What's up, everyone? Welcome, challengers. We're going over some nutritional hacks or how to correctly read a food label to make sure that you're getting the correct amount of nutrients and some things to look out for with those little, you know, pesky serving sizes and take into consideration. So today we're going to be reviewing some black beans and taking a look at the back and the food label, and we're going to go through all of the different components of the food labels, from the serving sizes to how many grams or ounces it has to what macronutrients and micronutrients, so proteins, carbs and fats, as well as minerals in there, and then some of the additives at the bottom. So let's go over from top to bottom of the food label. So you can see up at the top right over here that the serving size is the first thing that we're gonna have to look out for. So a lot of the times the serving size is gonna be smaller than the actual container that the food is coming in. So like, for example, for this can of beans that I have, it's half a cup per serving. And then if you look right down below that, it says servings per container, so those three. So if you eat this can of beans, you're gonna be getting three servings of what follows is the calories, and then the proteins, carbs, and fats. So just below that, there are calories. So for this specific can, there is 110 calories in the per serving, so 330 total. It's pretty good. It's pretty healthy. Black beans are really good for you. Some other things, not so much. But just below that, it goes through the total fat that's in the serving. So remember, this is all per serving, not per the whole can. So this one has 1 gram of fat, and below that it will break down saturated fats and trans fats. Not every label does this, but it's nice when it does, so you can help see which type of fats you're getting and which ones you kind of want to avoid. Below that it goes into cholesterol. Like again, I said, this isn't on every single food label, but it's a good information, some good information to have. And then some of the micronutrients, sodium levels. So we really want to take into consideration these sodium levels. This one serving of this half a cup has 400 milligrams, which is 17% of our daily recommended value. So really keep an eye out for those sodium levels. Make sure that we're not going up into the 120, 140 plus like some things have. A lot of cans and processed foods typically tend to have more sodium in them because they have to preserve them for shelf life. So that's why eating whole, fresh cut, prepared yourself foods are a lot better, because you can control the sodium intake and what you put in and what you don't put in. Then below that, we're gonna go into carbohydrates. So below, this one has 19 grams of carbohydrates. Below that, this is one of the next two pieces are super important, because it goes into fiber and sugar that's in there. So fiber is super important. We need it for a lot of digestive health, and it also will help slow the absorption rate of the carbohydrates, of the sugars and other things that are in there. So really, our whole foods and things that come from plants and whole grains have more fiber. They slow the rate of absorption of carbs, which is a whole nother topic on itself, but just look for fiber. You want anything from 4 to 5 grams of fiber, or upwards, you know, 7, like this one is a high source of fiber. Below that is sugar, and then sometimes even added sugar. So that's a key thing to look out for. So if it is added sugar, that means whoever is making this is putting in those little extra grams of sugar to make it extra sweet and tasty. We want to avoid this as much as possible. Sugar is not bad if it's wrapped in its, you know, natural case. It comes in it naturally, like fruits, so strawberries, bananas, things like that. They have their own source of fiber that then, again, like I said, slows that absorption rate for the carbohydrates. And then last but not least is protein of our macronutrients. So the protein content is at the bottom of each and every food label. So take a look at that. You'll see how many grams are in per serving. This one has 7 grams per serving, which is pretty good source of carbohydrates, or sorry, of proteins, if you're looking to get your protein sources from a non-meat or dairy source. Below that, it's going to break it down into its micronutrients, so vitamins, minerals, things of that nature, which your body needs to make sure that you're running properly and functioning correctly. They help play a lot of different roles, from hormone regulation to helping with, you know, even improving normal functions of the body, so how your muscles contract or how your sight is or how you taste, things of that nature. They all play a role, and there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of them. So making sure that we get enough micronutrients, again, whole foods, vegetables, things of that nature are going to be probably a very, very good source for you. If you need supplementation, that's a whole nother story. We'll get on that topic later. And then the last little bit, if you look over usually to the right or below, there's the ingredients. So for this one, it's water, black beans, and salt. That's it. Those are the only three ingredients in there. So the most of the content is water. So the order that it's listed in is gonna be the amount that is in the, or the percentages that is in the can or product or whatever it is. So if water is number one, that means there's more water than anything else in there. Then number two is black beans. So that means there's more, then the next thing is black beans. Remember that there's water in black beans, so that's why it might sound a little funky. And then the last thing is salt. So this has three ingredients. Other things, other cans, other products, you'll see some names that you probably can't even pronounce. Those are chemicals, additives, and preservatives. Try to stay away from those as much as you can. I know breads and things of that nature will have like enriched wheat, this wheat, that wheat. So you'll see all the different types of ingredients that are in there in different preservatives. So really you're trying to limit the total number of ingredients that are on there. And that pretty much wraps up our food how to read a food label. And just so you know, we are going to be doing these conversations and topics more and more and more, and we're really trying to give you guys the best content and teach you guys everything that I know and that, you know, and that I can provide you to be successful in your challenge. So I hope this helps, and I hope you find some value out of this. And if you'd like, you can go ahead and share it with your friends and family, and I'll see you later. Peace.